Broadcasting from the greatest castle in the world, in the County of Lawrence, NCTV 45.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
NCTV 45, The Train, anytime on your time.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Focus NC. You know, I couldn't resist. In these times where it's actually a little bit nauseating to turn on the news, I think there needs to be some reflection on a quote from two men in two different time periods, maybe close to 200 years apart. Ben Franklin, a great Pennsylvanian, said, "Men, we must all hang together, or surely we'll all hang separately." Now, throughout our history, we've been the great experiment, the builder of compromise, and something that everybody could be proud of as an American. But lately, this partisan politics and division has creeped in from everywhere. Could it be that we have not taught those youngsters, people younger than me, not necessarily children, our rich history? Could it be that we didn't teach them to be Americans first and citizens of the world second? Just because you're an American doesn't mean you crap on the rest of the world. But it means that you have an idea of why and how the country was founded. I see very little of that today. We are approaching an election, and we are in the midst of maybe nominating a Supreme Court justice. Now, you know, there's a lot of partisan politics that have played in this battle. First of all, the Constitution says that the president can nominate a candidate to the Supreme Court, which he has. It is up to the Senate to review and vote. We seem to be dragging our feet and trying to, in the meantime, drag a guy through the mud on unfounded charges. And the presumption of innocence until proven guilty seems to be a stall tactic to which there could be no end. Now, we're going to take a break, and when we come back, I'm going to talk more about this right after these messages.
We'll be right back.
Elham's for one great dining experience. On Target Printing, 1319 West State Street. No job is too big or too small. Turnaround on most jobs, 24 hours. We make you look good on paper. Welcome back. Yes, you know, the stall tactic is on. Now, it's one of those easy predictions as press releases come into this office regularly, as they come into many of the other news places, journalistic places across the state and country. The governor started with victims abuse maybe about 2 weeks ago, trying to drum up his position in this Supreme Court decision. Now, you know, it's okay to have strong beliefs and vote along party lines. That's fine. But when there becomes little to no basis for continued investigation, then you have to question, is destruction of the country worth that end? Is it worth running a person through the gutter? Is it worth not paying attention to the facts? Not compromising to cause a stage show in hopes that the decision is made closer to the election and it sways political opinion? As you sit back and look, you know, one side can claim what I just said. And the other side can talk about, well, we haven't investigated enough. But what seems to be an endless investigation needs to come to a conclusion. When is enough enough? Is it enough when you finally try to squirm to get your way? Is it enough when the system falls apart? Is it enough not to be strong enough to say, hey, you know what? We did the investigation. There's been no charges up until this point brought. It's over. If a tree falls in the forest, does it make a noise? Certainly. But if there's nobody there to hear it, how do you know what noise it made? You don't. You can't accuse a person of a crime with lack of evidence and witness. Thus, it becomes a real joke. Now, we're going to take this break, and when we get back, I'm going to tell you about the other American and what he said almost 200 years later. Today's programming furnished by a grant from Joseph's Supermarket. Special thanks to Joseph's. The Pokeberry Exchange at 41 North Mercer Street has gifts galore that'll make you want to explore. Lamps, homemade lamps of every shape and color that will excite any room in your house. Wind chimes hang from the door to give that sweet sound.
sweet soaps and teas, embroidered towels, and much more. It's the Polk Berry Exchange. It's yours to explore.
Welcome back. Yes, in 1776 or thereabouts, Ben Franklin made the quote that, "Men, we must all hang together, or surely we'll all hang separately." It seems funny that almost 200 years later, maybe short a few years, there was a song on the pop charts, "One Bad Apple Don't Spoil the Whole Bunch, Girl." Yeah, that made famous by Donny Osmond. And what a novel idea. As we see different movements claim that everybody's bad, okay, the same type of prejudice that caused problems for other different groups has spawned a way to criticize the right, has spawned a way to criticize men, has spawned a way to criticize somebody you don't agree with. Just because you don't agree with a person doesn't mean that the person is a bad apple. They might naturally have a different opinion. And to that, the bigger part is that in this country, we've always recognized other people's difference of opinion. And when we didn't, there was a bloody massacre. It was called the Civil War. Hopefully, we've learned enough not to go down that path again. And hopefully for those youngsters, younger than me, that haven't done their American history, they go back and do a little research. Remember, one bad apple doesn't spoil the whole bunch, girl. And if we don't hang together, surely, we'll hang separately. For Focus NC, I'm Angelo Ferrata. Have a great evening.